Thank you, Madam President. I rise in support of SR88, and the Bay Area Reporter, the LGBTQ newspaper for San Francisco, has with great glee pointed out that I am 45 years older than the youngest member of the LGBT caucus. I was taken aback by that at first, and then I decided the best way to embrace my longevity is to point out that I'm the only member of the LGBT caucus who actually met Harvey Milk. And it's interesting because I think we on this floor talk about Martin Luther King or Cesar Chavez or in this moment Harvey Milk, and we forget that there was a time when they weren't lionized, when they were a person with human frailties, where they actually are remembered because they drew a line at a time that nobody else was essentially drawing that line. And as I might have mentioned last year, when the movie Milk came out, I really didn't want to go see it because I knew how it ended. I actually knew the people around him much better. And there's that legendary scene when I did go to see it, where he is riding down in the parade holding a sign, "I'm from Woodmere, New York," and I think it was one of my first parades. I was there, I saw him go by. When he did that, and he was trying to point out that everybody came from somewhere, that there were people that were gay in all cities and locations in the country, and yet they didn't feel safe there, so it had to be pointed out when they got there. And I had a surprising takeaway from seeing that movie, and it was you forget what it was like in his time. Because there was a particular scene where they had activists organized because gay bars would just be raided. The right to peaceably assemble was not respected. And they would have people on call to all rush over to a place when there might be heads being cracked or people being rousted just for peaceably assembling because they were gay. And you forget, you look at the victories that happened since then, and you forget what it was like in the moment and what he was facing. And I was trying to think of something new to say, and I remembered there, for those of us on the Democratic side of the aisle, there's an organization called the California Democratic Council. And it was really much more active in the earlier years. And I would go to the CDC conventions. And the Briggs Initiative qualified very early. It qualified at least a year before it was voted on in November of 1978. So the first organization in the Democratic Party that had what was called then a gay and lesbian caucus was the CDC. And Jerry Brown would not oppose the Briggs Initiative when it first qualified. So there was a huge debate in that caucus, and it was interesting. It was Harvey Milk arguing to not endorse Jerry Brown, and Mervyn Dimely, who was the lieutenant governor, arguing to endorse Jerry Brown. And Mervyn Dimely had credibility because gay behavior was illegal, and it was legalized. And when it came to this very chamber, where I'm standing right now, the vote was 2020. It required Mervyn Dimely to fly in from somewhere and go to the podium and cast the tie-breaking vote. So he had credibility. In the end, two things happened. The caucus did not endorse Jerry Brown, but Jerry Brown came around. And before he endorsed it, and even convinced President Jimmy Carter in the week before the election to oppose the Briggs Initiative. And it was just Harvey Milk was going to draw the line and force the issue in a way that it just hadn't been forced. And that started to cause the change that is the reason many of us are here today. And one of the other things he said, and the senator from Berkeley was very good in her comments about offering hope, is he talked about, he would pick a city, but frequently he picked Altoona, Pennsylvania for some reason, that there was this poor kid sitting by himself in Altoona, Pennsylvania with no hope and not thinking there was anybody else that was like him. And so I had the honor when the first of us that were elected The first three of us that were ever openly gay mayors in the history of the United States were elected in 1983, and I was invited a few days later to speak to the fifth annual Milk Moscone Candlelight March in San Francisco, and I was able to say, we have the first returns from Altoona, because many of us were stepping up because he drew the line, and yes, at that time, there were 10 or 12 out officials in the entire United States. There are more out officials in the Monterey Bay Area now than there were in the entire United States when I was elected to local office. And so it's because he drew that line. It's because he paved the way, because he let some of us know we could do it. So regardless of the human frailty or how he made the decisions that were out of the limelight that drew the line that led him to where he was, there's a reason we should honor him today, because he made a fundamental difference in many people's lives. And so I'm proud to rise in support of SR88.